Can I just ask where you found Freddy? Because I think he's absolutely fantastic in this film.
I found Freddy in the tea room of the Athenaeum Hotel in London. That's where I met him for the first time. And he didn't read for the part. He just came in and he had tea for about an hour. And I just fell in love with him. And I felt like this man is the King of France. I mean, I was blown away by him, absolutely blown away by him. And I think, you know, because it's a very difficult role to play. He's got to be a young man and he's got to have this aristocratic bearing. And I think, in a way, Freddie coming from kind of acting royalty really, really helped. So I'm so proud of him. I feel like he's my little discovery.
Now, do you have a vendetta against James Corden, or did you just want to see him?
Definitely a vendetta. He was under the impression he was on some kind of hidden camera show because he hated coming to set so much, because every time he comes to set, we'd load him up with things. So the first scene we shot with him was the end of the movie where he's carrying all this food and a big blancmange and a big ham and a big fish. So not only was it really heavy, he could hardly stand up. It just stank really badly and he was covered in flies because it was quite a warm day. Then the next scene we shot with him is when the Musketeers are in Calais and he's carrying all of their luggage. And we had a French dresser on set, and all of the stuff he's carrying is real antique stuff from the 17th century, but it was real, so it was really heavy. So every day, and then I think the next thing we shot with him is when he tries to bring the Musketeers lunch, where he's carrying like a huge plate, massive cheeses and breads. Then the next time he was carrying logs. So he just thought we were playing some elaborate joke on him.
The budget for this is not insubstantial. What was your best spend, do you think? What were you most proud of commissioning? Yes, I want that made.
I think that my favorite set in this movie and my favorite set that I've ever had built is the flying airships. Mm. Because my approach to visual effects is they have their place. I think they can work really well, but the more you can build practically, the better I like the visual effect, because the more of the image that can be real, the better the visual effect works. So we built a huge chunk of these flying ships, like the whole front of them. They were four stories high. We had three rows of cannons that came out and really fired. I mean, it was like a giant toy come to life. So for a boy like me, it was just awesome. And it was great. I mean, the actors loved it. The only problem I had was every time I was up there with the three Musketeers, they would fight about who would get to steer the ship. Everyone wanted to steer the ship. And then one of them, only one could steer, obviously. Then the fight would be, well, I want the telescope to kind of look at it. So blocking those scenes was a little challenging. But otherwise, I mean, it was such fun.
What's happened to the ship now? Is it in some storage container somewhere? Or?
We shot the stage work in Babelsberg, mm-hmm. which is the big studio in Berlin. And they have a studio tour, a bit like Universal. And the ship has actually become part of their studio tour.
That's great news.
So the ship's preserved. And then one of my other favorite sets was we built a whole Venetian canal indoors for the action scene with Luke Evans at the start of the movie. And that's been preserved as well. So yeah, it was complete with gondolas and everything.
And who came up with the ideas for all the guns? Because there's a Gatling gun, which is also a cannonball firing super machine. And it's those moments that really got to make my eyes blow up.
I don't know who invented that Gatling gun, because that's based on a real 17th century weapon. So somebody in the 17th century came up with that genius idea. We built one that copied the one we found, but the one we found was in a museum in Bavaria. It was identical. And it really had one fuse and all these cannons that would rotate. And as soon as the cannon got in line with the fuse, it would fire. And so many of the weapons in the movie, they kind of feel very James Bondian, but they're based on real 17th century weaponry. You know, at that period of human history, people were really putting a lot of effort into designing inventive ways to kill one another.
And how did you go about doing the whole Tower of London scenes? Was that, because you say you obviously emphasize on real sets rather than all, you know, your own versions of them. How did you even begin to shoot scenes there?
Well, we started by doing helicopter shots over the real Tower of London. So we got the architecture and the symmetry of the buildings correct and the relationship with the Thames correct. And then we projected a digital version over the top of the real imagery. So what you're seeing is really what the Tower of London looked like, which I think is it's so much more impressive than it is now, where it's surrounded by tourist shops, right? Yeah. Back then, when it really had the giant moat around it, I mean, it was just fantastic. Then we shot on some real locations for the exteriors where you get those giant walls. And then obviously Orlando's office which was a huge set, which it had to be because there are very few real period locations that were allowed to go in there and explodicate it.